Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at some new features in DaVinci Resolve 19 that's just been out of public beta for a little while now. And there has been some new transitions, some new fusion effects, and some new generators, which are kind of cool, that are in DaVinci Resolve 19. So let's not waste any more time, and let's just jump right to the tutorial. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 19, and let's just get started by having a look at the new fusion transitions. And I did do a video all about the fusion transitions inside of DaVinci Resolve, and if you want to know more about all of them, you can actually have a look right up here in the top corner. There will be the video. However, we are only going to take a look at the new fusion transitions in the version 19, the new ones added when you update from the beta to the version 19. So let's just do that. So first up, let's go up to the transitions, and we're just going to go down here to the fusion transitions. And the first of the new one is the block glitch transition. So I'm just going to put that on my clip here, and we can have a look at how that looks, as you see right there. And of course, as usually, we can select the transition itself and go over to the inspector. And over here, we can do different functions, different things. If we go into the middle here, we can go in and change the frequency and the aspect and the random seed and all of these things here. So now we've done a little own version of it. That is something you can do with all of the transitions, by the way. So I'm just going to delete this and I'll go to the next one. Now we have the block twist, which is this one here, and we can have a look at how that looks. Is this a usable transition? Yeah, for something, maybe. The next one is the box wipe transition, which is right here, and we can have a look at that as well, which is actually a pretty cool transition, and you might be able to do something very cool with that. So we also have one called disarrange, which is right here, and we're going to add that in as well, so you can see what that does. I think that is pretty cool. Might be a cool use for that in some scenarios, I think. Next one would be the elastic rubber, which is a little bit strange, I think, but nevertheless, it's here. Is it useful? Maybe for something. I don't really know. I can't see myself using this, but hey, maybe I'm going to use it in every video from now on. So maybe, or maybe not. The next is the rewipe, which is down here. And that is the last one of the new ones, which is pretty cool. And again, can be used for something. Again, all of the colors and border width and stuff like that can be changed in the inspector. So if we just jump over to the generators here, we actually have some new stringer transitions. And there is like 21 of them or something like that. And these are something you can add in like that. And we can actually show you pretty quickly here. I'm just going to take this, find the middle, and then it's going to do like a transition between the two clips like that. And I did do a video all about that. So if you want to have a look at that video, you can just go up here in the top corner. It's more in depth on how things work. So check that out. Also, we have some fusion generators. We have, for instance, the vintage texture, which we can put that in here. And that is pretty cool, you see here. And if we select the clip, we can go up to the inspector. And for instance, we go into the generator, we can take the dark texture. We can take that off so it'd be more like a white texture. And we can actually, you can use this for a lot of things. For instance, if you take this clip here and put the generator on top. For instance, we can do like that, and then we can go into this, and we can go into the settings here, and we could, for instance, just go into the opacity and lower the opacity, and then we could do some kind of a texture over top of things, which is kind of cool, and you can just make it longer or shorter as you please. In the fusion generators, we also have a comic speed line, which is right here, and I think if you just take a look at that, you can do some cool stuff with that. Let's take this clip here and put that on top. So we could do something like this. Maybe that could be useful for something. And then again, if we go into the clip itself, we can go into the generator and we can change the speed of this. We can change the texture of it, and this, we can stretch the line, or we can change the angle of it as well. which I think could be kind of cool. So we could pretty much do whatever we want with this. Maybe that would be kind of useful for something. Also, we have a couple of new effects also in the Fusion effects. Let's just take a clip here. Let's take the priest clip here and just going to do a cut. So if we go into the effects, we can see that we have the flying flag effect. We can add that in here. I don't really know what I would be using this for, but it's there if we really need it. I'm not so sure we do. However, there is another one, which I think is kind of cool. It is the comic book, and we can actually add that in here. So we're going to make our clip more into a comic book style shot like this, which I think is really, really, really cool. And then, of course, we could, again, select the clip, go into the inspector, and in the inspector, we can change the scale image here, so we can really scale it however we want. And we could do keyframes too if we want to, so that's super cool. We can change the angle of the image here as we please. We can go into the texture blend and we can blend in the textures, which I think is cool. The inner frame graphics, we can change that. And again, these are keyframeable, so we could actually add things in. Again, we also have a background stuff. We could do something with the background, make something cool, a cool little look here. The frame width, we can change the frame width and stuff like that. I think we could actually make some pretty cool stuff. And again, we could change the colors of everything, make this look really cool comic book-like. So that was a look at some of the new features in DaVinci Resolve 19. I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's another video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.